How will you feel if you wake up one morning and saw a big M16 as large a jar? Feel like you want disappear, but you can't.
Welcome to Agents of S.C.R.E.E.N, the first and only place to come to for movie reviews live at the cinema. It's your boy Miles, and we're back again with our weekly Power Breakdown, Season 6, Episode 7. Only 3 episodes left, what's gonna take place? But before we get to that, have you seen The Joker yet? What a phenomenal performance from Joaquin Phoenix. Make sure you check out our review for that, which should be in the link up here or in the description below, or just on our channel in general. But that being said, let's get into what you came for. Now, the episode opens with Tariq sleeping in bed. You know, he's having a very peaceful sleep, but that's going to be short-lived as Ghost wakes him up. He rudely wakes him up. Tariq was sleeping peacefully, and then all of a sudden, gun in his face, it was like,
how would you feel if you wake up one morning and saw a big M16 as large a jar? Feel like you want to disappear, but you can't.
Only the real ones know about that tune there. But what a toxic household. In what household does your father wake you up with a gun to your face and he's saying, wake up little bitch, sleepy time's over? Like, what kind of house is this, bruv? Ghost confronts Tariq about everything that's been taking place, the whole Proctor thing, the drugs going missing, Tommy, school, all of that. They have a heart-to-heart, well, seemingly a heart-to-heart. What I found funny about that scene is that Ghost asks for Tariq's word that he won't talk to Tommy again. But then Tariq never gives him his word, and the scene just ends. So we know Tariq is a lying bastard, so we know he's gonna break his trust. You know, he cannot be trusted. We gotta fast forward to Tommy's warehouse, where they finally discover that drugs have been missing. Tariq's been stealing them. They don't know that 2-Bit, Spank, and BG are in there. They don't realize that Lakeisha is also in the warehouse. She's seen everything. Accusations get thrown around, but 2-Bit is wiling. He is wildin'. Altercation takes place and he says to her that he was gonna snatch her chain. Like, you can't say that to her next man's bae. You can't say that. There's no coming back from that. And just when you thought it couldn't get any worse, he grabs her by the arm. This nigga's looking to lose his life out here. Now, when I saw this happen, I was thinking, okay, this is gonna be the last time we see this guy on screen. Even though he wasn't the one who actually stole the pills, you can't do that. So I thought he was gonna die in this episode. And as it transpired, Tommy actually spared him, but I thought it was guaranteed death for this Donnie. Now we're gonna fast forward to the campaign office. Ramona comes in, she's looking for Governor Tate. Where is he? He's at a prayer breakfast. Like, what's if anyone knows what a prayer breakfast is, please put that in the comments below. I would ask what takes place there, but at the same time, it seems like it's self-explanatory. Prayers and breakfast. Tell me what they eat there. Do they eat croissants? Is it toast? Is it a full English breakfast, or is it just like the body and blood of Christ? What Ramona drops one of the bars of the season in this scene, because she's asking, where is he? He's at the prayer breakfast at the Baptist church. And Ramona says, well, God ain't gonna help him win this primary. I am now. Talk your shit, babe. Talk that talk. I like when a woman talks spicy. I love that. Speaking of spicy, Office Bay is back. I can't remember her name, but the last time we saw her was in another sex scene with Governor Tate. And fast forward to now, it's another sex scene with Governor Tate. Like, is it like in her contract that she has to have a sex scene every time she appears on screen? That's a bit wild, isn't it? And speaking of wild, I didn't know she was married to my man in the office, the white don. But I thought he was gay, but they were married. Maybe I wasn't paying attention in that scene beforehand, or I missed that. But did you guys realize that she was married to my guy? I didn't realize at all. But in that scene, as I said, Ramona was in the office. Where is Governor Tate? Where is Office Bay? Both of their absences. This something seems a bit fishy here. So he immediately goes into the hotel room and he finds them cheating. There wasn't a condom inside. It was raw. It's one thing to cheat, but it's quite another to cheat with no condom. So I hear. I have no idea about anything like that. Even before this episode, I had to Google what cheating means. But my question in this scene is, one, how did he find the hotel room? You could argue he's his like campaign manager, so he knows Governor Tate's location. Okay, I could buy that. And two, how was the door open? How is man just walking into the room like that? It's a bit wild, isn't it? And this whole escapade threatens to ruin Governor Tate's campaign, but Ghost and Ramona, they both straighten shit out. They make them both sign NDAs, so everyone wins. Kind of like a House of Cards situation. No Kevin Spacey. Now we're gonna fast forward again. Tommy meets up with Jason to discuss how they're gonna move forward with the distro, getting more weight, and you see an unexpected guest. You see Sucre. All my Prison Break guys will know about Sucre. It was good to see him. I ain't seen him in anything in time. He just had one little scene in it. Maybe we're gonna see him more in the last three episodes, because there was discussions about Tommy going to the West Coast, possibly. Now we're gonna go back to Tariq again. He's scrambling around trying to see what he could do. Ghost or Tasha, Tommy, who will help him? He goes to Dre. Dre owes him a favor, so Dre gives him a key of whatever he gave him. But what I wanna understand is, why is Tariq so craving? Why is he so craving to sell drugs? I've never seen someone pursue becoming a drug dealer so hard, so unnecessarily. You've had everything that you wanted in your life, all the money, penthouse, every game you could have wanted, access to the best schools and education. You just, you ungrateful swine, man. I don't want to hear about, oh, that's just who you are, like it's in your blood. Like, what are people like rewriting science textbooks now, what being a drug dealer is in your blood? Come on now. Even from that standpoint, Tariq's character is very annoying. It defies all logic. So as I said earlier, the Keisha BG two-bit span, they realize that drugs have gone missing. It's a mystery. Who has stolen it? They have suspicions. Tasha thinks it's Tariq. Tommy thinks, no, there's no way. He wouldn't lie to me. He wouldn't steal from me. I've known this boy since he's a baby. So they arrange to meet up. They're on the rooftop. Tommy asks him as a man, did you steal the drugs? Did you do? Don't lie to me. Tariq starts off with a lie, but shortly the jig is up. Tommy knows. Tommy makes him admit, not makes him, but kind of coerces him. And he finally admits, yes, I did take your drugs. I was desperate at the time. I didn't know what to do. And he goes to throw him over the rooftop, but he doesn't. You know, Tariq's having a tough day. Like, he woke up in the morning, his father's putting a gun in his face, and now his uncle's threatening him to throw him off a rooftop like Vanilla Ice. It's wild, isn't it? So wow, what a day. But I don't care though, he deserves that. So after Tommy finds out it was Tariq that stole the drugs, he returns to the warehouse. 2-Bit, Spank, BG are there. They confront each other about the whole situation. It's gonna escalate. Looks like something's gonna pop off in the warehouse. It gets calmed down, but Tommy says to them, like, yo, listen, cool, you man didn't steal it, but I can't excuse you putting my hand on my bait. Can't excuse all of that wild shit he was talking. So he fires them. But 2-Bit and Spank immediately are thinking of how they're gonna get back in. So they decide to send someone to shake up Lakeisha in hope that she would decide to leave the ends, leave New York, and leave Tommy's side, because in their view, ever since she's come on the scene, shit has been going left. So they hire a goon. The goon goes to her hair salon, but she's there by herself. It's nighttime, it's dark. Where did they get this goon from? Where did they find this bootleg goon from, man? I guess they found him in the Yellow Pages or something, because he can't do anything right. Even to barricade the door, he put an umbrella, like, an umbrella's gonna stop a door from opening. Like, come on, bro, Lord, some plastic. I almost went through the whole entire video without updating the La La Bum Bum watch. But, you know, unfortunately, it's attached to the most annoying character currently in the show. Now, throughout this whole entire episode, she's been moaning and groaning, not in a nice way either. She's been nagging, saying, like, this is too much. I don't want to hold the gun. Like, we need to get out of the game. And at the start of the season, she was like, oh, I'll do whatever. I'll ride or die, whatever you need me to do. Like, even in the previous episode, she was saying, like, what? If you need me to kill ghosts, I'll do it. Now she's crying every minute. Now look at that. Life comes at you fast, doesn't it? But to close out the episode, Tariq and Tasha are talking. She's trying to find out what's going on with her son. Like, what do you want from life? Like, what do you want to do? Cut all the bullshit. Don't lie to me, all of that. He opens up to her and says, like, oh, I've gone to this person and asked for help. They said no. I've gone to that person and asked for help. They said no. I just want some help to do this thing right. She decides, as his mother, to teach him the game. You see, like, last season he was like, teach me the motherfucking game, ghost. Like, now he's learning from his mother. What would you do in this situation? Your son, he's in the game, you want to get him out, he's not listening to you. Would you help him sell drugs, or would you take some other course of action? Because from my perspective, as I said, this is a toxic household. How can you be doing this? This is too easy. Come on. He's been taking them for a ride all season. Anything he's wanted, he's gotten. He sold drugs, he's got himself kidnapped. He gave aspirin to another drug dealer and tried to pass it off as a real thing. He sold out Procter. He was willing to sell out his dad as well, and now they're teaching him how to sell drugs. What's going on, Tasha? With Tasha, she's worse than Ghost Rap now. Like, if she's not looking for new man to tech, she's teaching her son how to sell drugs. Like, come on, darling. Come on. I guess this is an example of what could happen in the absence of regular skin-to-skin action, you know? She ain't had a man in a while, and look what's going on with her. It's peak. But that's my wrap up for episode 7 of the latest season, season 6 of Power. Hope you enjoyed. What is your take on what's happening? There's only 3 episodes left. How is this gonna end? And Tommy and Ghost gonna have to join forces again? Well, it looks like it. Is Governor Tate gonna win his campaign? Highly unlikely. Something's gonna happen. Oh shit, how dare I? Even though he was a minor-ish character. R.I.P. to BG, you know, he lost his life in this episode. Dre got the jump on him, took advantage of the fact that he was soft-hearted. What's your number? 9-1, bang, straight through the jaw. He died in Tim's. What a way to go as well. But yeah, that's my wrap up. As always, I've been your boy Miles. Make sure you like, share and subscribe from all of us at Agents of S.C.R.E.E.N. Until next week for the next Power episode, or even not till then, until the next video period. As I said, make sure you check out our Joker review. Peace.